In this video, we're going to take a look at Dell Container Storage Modules, a GitOps ready platform. We're going to deploy CSI drivers automatically through the Azure Arc Kubernetes GitOps module to automatically manage our application through code in a CI/CD pipeline. So this is our architecture. Now let's have a look and see how we can do this. Okay, so this is our cluster with two nodes, no CSI driver installed, and no storage classes set up. First of all, we need to connect to our cluster to the Kubernetes portal in Azure. Do that with the Azure CLI. So just ran the command and refreshed. So we see the new cluster has appeared in the portal. You can see that there's two nodes. I'm going to configure some additional monitoring. So in order to do that, I'm going to set up a service account. That service account will give me visibility into the memory and CPU utilization through the Azure portal, which is handy if I'm trying to troubleshoot. I may also want to monitor the namespaces and storage classes through the Azure portal. So in order to do that, I'll use the same user and generate a secret for that to sign in from the portal. So using the getSecret command in kubectl, I'm going to generate the secret, copy that, and just paste that in. So we're almost all set up in the Azure Arc portal and ready to start the GitOps deployment. So now we can start setting up the GitOps workflow. So we've got our monorepo structure set up in GitHub as follows. I'm going to use the Flux version 2 in Azure and link in with our configuration in GitHub. So we're going to give it a name, in this case infrastructure, the namespace, which should match what we have in our GitHub repository, which is Flux System. Our scope is cluster-wide because we want to install these components on every node in the cluster. And we also want this to be continuous reconciliation. So if we make any changes, those will get picked up and through a pull will be resolved on our cluster automatically. So within the customization, we specify where on our GitOps repository our customization lies. So this is, we give it the instance name and the path to the top layer of our customization. In this case, it's under multi-tenant and infrastructure. So here we have our customization.yaml, which contains all of the components that are going to be applied. So we're going to install the PowerMax external snapshotter and the CSM replication modules, as well as the cert manager. So just put that information into the GitOps config. We're going to reconfigure the sync settings because we want to reconcile maybe every 5 minutes instead of every 10. It's customizable. And once that's done and applied, we will see within the GitOps workflow that things are now configuring. Okay, so we have our pipeline set up, and if we go back to the cluster and take a look at what's running, the get pods command, you can see that the snapshot controller and the replication controller have been installed. We go back into the Azure Arc interface, we can see the infrastructure Git repository is now compliant, and we're just pending some of the customizations. So it's rolling out the changes to install the infrastructure components as we've described in the code in GitHub and the GitOps repository. So if we just refresh a couple of times, we see that this is eventually goes into a compliant state. And if we look at the pods, we will see now that the PowerMax CSI driver has been installed, as well as the other components that we've specified earlier. We look at the storage classes. We now see that we have the storage classes for the different projects that we've configured. So we've got our different classes available. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.